Welcome to Muscle Shoals, Alabama, the home of the world famous Muscle Shoals sound.
Muscle Shoals, Alabama, country roads where white cotton grows.
The waters of the Tennessee River have washed up a sound where they cross the treacherous shoals at the Natchez Trace. Centuries ago, it came from pioneers who played musical instruments to pass time while waiting for the river to subside. The current still pull musicians here, but now the only waiting is to get inside a studio. Today, Muscle Shoals boasts 9 studios, and they produce a sound found nowhere else in the country. Artists come to Muscle Shoals hoping to leave with a little more soul. What is laid down on tape here is the music inherent to Northern Alabamans, rhythm and blues.
It's that thumping bass, that good thumping bass, and funky, soulful licks that it's played, and it's a snare, good solid snare. And it's just basic funky music, you know, it comes out of Alabama.
There's a bunch of white country-bred musicians who somewhere along the line took a left turn to the blues.
The recording industry's history in Muscle Shoals is the story of one man, Rick Hall. His 24-track studio is a long way from the dilapidated warehouse he used as a mono recording facility in 1960.
I find it very hard to compete with Nashville or Memphis dealing in country music and in pop, top 40 music. So the only way I could really get my foot in the door was to work with black acts, and I found that there was a wide open area there.
The black bass sound is not the only reason Muscle Shoals has become a successful recording center.
Muscle Shoals is known for its funky rhythm and blues music. W.C. Handy, the father of the blues, was born in Florence. Dexter Johnson, uncle of Muscle Shoals Sound Studios' Jimmy Johnson, established their first studio in the area. Dexter was a member of the Blue Seal Pals. He used to play the Grand Ole Opry. Another forerunner in Muscle Shoals music is James Dwight.
Another track I'm very proud of is the honor they gave me in 1971. This plaque of honor here for being the first to bring the Muscle Shoals to prominence in music. And I certainly commend all these musicians and the record people have done such a tremendous job here in bringing Muscle Shoals to international fame, known all over the world.
Joyner recorded the regional hit A Fallen Star on Bobby Denton, now a local government leader. The song later became a national hit by Jimmy C. Newman. Also active in the old Muscle Shoals area country bands was Woody Richardson, who now has Woodridge Studio in Lexington, where he cuts mostly gospel and country. Narville Phelps' Reconsider Me, the number one Billboard country single of 1975, was cut at the Music Mill Studio. Phelps, John Wesley Riles, Hank Williams Jr., Sherry Bryce, yeah, Bobby Bear, Roy Clark, Willie Nelson, and others came here for the Muscle Shoals touch. Rock and roll in the late 50s spawned many bands in the Muscle Shoals area. Members of those early bands are now the leaders in Muscle Shoals. One of those bands was the Fairlanes. A key member of that group, Rick Hall, who became the father of Muscle Shoals music. One of his fellow Fairlanes, Billy Sherrill, and Hall joined Tom Stafford in 1960 in a makeshift studio over City Drugs in Florence, owned by Stafford's father. This was the beginning of Florence, Alabama music enterprises. Sherrill left for Nashville. Stafford stayed in Florence. Hall moved on to a Muscle Shoals warehouse. The first product was You Better Move On by Arthur Alexander, the first hit out of Muscle Shoals.
You asked me to give up the hand of the girl I love.
From there to today's Fame Studios, where Hall produced Steal Away by Jimmy Hughes.
I've got to see you.
Hall's early success was solidified by his ability to pick musicians for the famed Muscle Shoals rhythm section. The Pickers have since established themselves as studio owners and producers of R&B, pop, and country. Among them were David Briggs, Norbert Putnam, Jimmy Johnson, Barry Beckett, and Pete Carr. The gold began pouring out of Fame.
What kind of fool do you think I am? Everybody! Hold on to what you got.
Jerry Wexler, an Atlantic Records producer, was the first major record company executive to recognize the potential of Muscle Shoals. Wexler brought Prattville, Alabama native Wilson Pickett to fame to cut the first of many Muscle Shoals gold records for Atlantic. Wexler and Hall smoothed their touch with Aretha Franklin and a two-sided hit.
Love a man the way that I love you. If you wanna do right, do right, Hall, do right, day, do right, woman.
A string of 20 gold records by black artist followed, like Clarence Carter.
Too weak to fight, can you slip away?
Arthur Conley. One of Hall's favorite and biggest productions was this gold record by Clarence Carter. In the late 60s, Hall began spreading into the pop charts.
What's that thing you got hanging out between your legs there?
Between my legs?
Yeah, this is my bag, man. Bag, well, what's that, all that furry looking, fuzzy looking stuff hanging on?
That's just part of my bag. We're gonna take this bag, Em.
What are you gonna do? What are you
gonna do? I got my guitar. It's gonna be coming through the bag, coming through the tube, and it's gonna be coming into the mic, and we're gonna boogie with it.
What you gonna do? We're gonna put that tube in your mouth?
We got her in there.
Let me. Can you make it talk? Can you make that bag talk?
We might be able to. Let's see what we got here.
Make it say something.
Lord have mercy. You hear that?
Yeah, I like that.
All right, we're gonna boogie one time now.
Yeah, that's good.
Let me hear the phone for this.
Yeah.
1971 was a big year for Rick Hall. He made an imprint on the national charts with 16 productions. He was awarded the Producer of the Year award by Billboard magazine.
I can tell you've been hurt by that look on your face, girl. Some guy brought a sad pain to your happy world. You need love, but you're afraid that if you give in, someone else will come along and suck you to your game. One bad apple don't spoil the whole bunch, girl.
I love the little wiggle in your walk, the way you cuddle on my shoulder. But you're too young to know the score. So come back when you're older, cause you're too sweet.
Just kept coming with a wide variety of artists.
Girl, you're getting that look in your eyes, and it's starting to worry me. I ain't ready for no family ties. Nobody's gonna hurry me. Just keep it friendly, girl, cause I don't wanna leave. Don't start clinging to me, girl, cause I can't breathe.
Baby, baby, don't get hooked on me.
Ron Ballew opened Widget Studio in 1972. Guitarist Pete Carr began his producing career there with Sail Cat and a hit of Motorcycle Mama.
You're 18, you can do what you like. You can be the queen of my highway. My Motorcycle Mama, you'll see the world for my Harley.
Who are those young men?
They make some of that great music that comes out of muscle shows.
Band in the 60s was the Del Rays. Jimmy Johnson was the leader of that band.
Went to the fortune teller, had my fortune read. I didn't know what to tell her. I had a dizzy feeling in my head.
Jimmy Johnson, Barry Beckett, David Hood, and Roger Hawkins were the nucleus of Rick Hall's rhythm section in the late 60s. In 1969, the foursome formed their own studio, Muscle Shoals Sound. They opened with Cher Bono. Golden success was almost immediate.
Take a letter, Maria. I'll press it to my wife. Say I won't be coming home.
R.B. Greaves, Joe Tex, Boz Skaggs, Leon Russell, Mel and Tim.
Starting all over again is gonna be rough. So rough. But we gonna make it. Oh yeah. Loving you is wrong. I don't wanna be right. Right means being without you. I'd rather live a wrong doing right. Your mom and daddy say it's a shame, it's a downright disgrace. But long as I got you by my side, I don't care what your people say.
Let me
1972, David Hood and Roger Hawkins joined Traffic on tour. Now back to the studio for more sessions.
In my little town, still crazy after all these years. Oh, still crazy.
There's been another man that I've needed and I've loved. But that hasn't made me love you less. And he knows he can't possess me. Never will. It's just this emptiness inside of me that only he can fill. Torn between two lovers.
That tune firmly established Barry Beckett as a record producer.
I am sailing. Again, across the sea, working on a night move, trying to make some front page driving news, working on a night move. First you take my heart in the palm of your hands and you squeeze it. Then you take my mind and play with it all.
In the spring of 1978, Muscle Shoals Sound opened its new multi-studio complex on the banks of the Tennessee River. Joe Cocker christened its first session. The Staples followed. Muscle Shoals Sound on the River is housed in a former three-story Naval Reserve Center. It's the largest single building housing recording studios in the world. In 1966, Quinn Ivey, a local DJ, opened Quinby Studio. He used Rick Hall's rhythm section for a session on a local singer, Percy Sledge, and gold resulted.
When a man loves a woman, can't keep his mind on nothing else. Then be wrapped you in the warm and tender love.
Ivey eventually sold his studio to his engineer, David Johnson, who changed the name to Broadway Sound and recorded acts like Jinx, Lynyrd Skynyrd, and Freddie North.
Friend, don't take her, she's all I've got. Please don't take her love away from me. I'm begging you, friend, don't take her, she's all I've got.
In 1971, Terry Woodford and Clayton Ivey left Muscle Shoals Sound to form Wishbone. Initially, it was a production company signed exclusively with Motown. In February of 78, they opened the first 24-track studio in Muscle Shoals.
goes to show that you really don't know. While you're out painting the town, do you think I'm home just sitting around waiting on you? Now who's really the fool? When I first found out, I hurt all over. I felt so left out till I got to know her. So I tried the way that she got over, and I became just a lot of her. So don't be surprised if I let the angel in your arms this morning. It's gonna be the devil in someone else's arms tonight. We've got the right feeling at the wrong time.
It's a crazy world, but I live here.
You told me when the Mississippi sun shines down on your brother, it will change your opinion on love.
She was lonely, no one really cared. Just a prisoner of a love that was unfair. She really wanted him, but he was never there. Now she's looking for a lover, for the lonely nights to share. And the midnight light shining from a window, a loving light.
Muscle Shoals, Alabama calls itself the hit recording capital of the world. And on the walls of the studios are the gold records, the million-dollar sellers. If you take the ratio of the number of recording sessions in each city compared to its percentage of hits on the charts, Muscle Shoals comes out on top. Yet on its music row, not one record company has an office.
It's that there's practically nothing else to do except music here, so that's why it's so darn good, you know.
Muscle Shoals is not a record factory. When an artist books time here, it's usually for the entire day or night, in studios owned by musicians or producers, not businessmen who know nothing about the industry. The biggest attraction to Muscle Shoals, though, are these men, the studio musicians whose livelihood is dependent upon making the record charts.
The musicians are in the same bag as people like me, independent producers. We're all just as good as our last record. If I had a number one record a month ago, or 6 months ago, or a year ago, that don't mean necessarily I'll ever have another hit record, so I have to keep proving myself.
The musicians that work here, interested in my record. It's their record too. They're not side men. They're not just a bunch of guys playing for the money. And that kind of caring is like something that is handmade. It's priceless.
Muscle Shoals doesn't yet have the stature of Nashville or LA as a recording center, but it's growing, and each day the Muscle Shoals sound gets louder and louder.
The Muscle Shoals sound spreads. One of the Muscle Shoals Music Association directors is Adam Seth.